and get ready. And I hope you guys will stick around and celebrate baptism with these people. It's going to be awesome. Amen? God bless you. Check, 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 check. Hey Jeff, can you turn this up? Because a lot of people are going to be out like this talking. Check it, turn it up. Check, check, check. Checkamundo, you probably have to bring up the gain. Check, check, check. One, two. Okay. Yeah, because people are going to be talking back here. You know. Yeah. All right. All right, guys, come on. Where's Paul at? Where's Paul? Paul, are you doing music?
Paul and Phil.
Paul, you're doing music, right? All right, you guys. For those of us, a lot of us know exactly what baptism is, but I want to review it with you, that this is a commandment of Christ after we believe. Notice, after we believe, and after we are saved and heaven bound, okay, nothing's going to change that. We are baptized. And we're baptized as a symbol, as a sacred ritual that... This thing is crazy. Anybody got a dime? I know you got a dime? No? Or a screwdriver? This thing's not staying there. Anybody got a screwdriver? Paul? Okay. My handy grandson always has one.
Like,
Come on, Sean. Give Sean a big hand.
Hey, the handyman.
Okay, there we go. That little guy grew up in the church, and when he was like about this tall, he was Shawnee. He's so handy now, you would never know he would have done this, but he was experimenting with the electrical outlets at the old church way back when, and he took a piece of clothes hanger and put it in both of the sockets. It burned his hands, and we had to bring him over to the children's hospital, and it was this big emergency right in the middle of service. That was my Shawnee. And so now he has his first son, and he gives him the middle name Danger. So I understand that. So it's a sacred time. But guys, this doesn't save anybody. This is a work that we do. It says in the scriptures, for it is by grace you are saved, through faith, that not of yourselves, not by works, you see, including baptism, so that no one, or so that only those can be saved. It's by grace through faith. Faith alone in Jesus Christ. So that's what it's about. And so we're going to just do this. And it's a special time for Jesus. He is here watching this. He is here participating in this. And we're going to be praying for everybody. And I'm going to ask those who desire to give a little shout out to Jesus about why they love him or whatever it may be that comes out of their hearts. They've got an open mic here. So I'm hoping everybody will before they get wet. And then we'll go into baptism, okay? Thank you, buddy. Okay. Miss Alicia. This is one of my precious family. She's so sweet. This is Alicia Paciolas. This is Dustin's daughter and his wife. You want to say anything, honey?
No, not really. I just really like Jesus.
There you go. I'm going to take your towel and I'll hand it to you.
There we go. Okay, she likes Jesus. All right. I like him too. Come on.
Before I say anything, I just want to say thank you, everybody. I love Jesus so much that he touched me so much that he came to me in a dream. And even when I said, you know, if you're real, show me. He shook me up really hard saying, why you're not listening to me? This time I have a better relationship with him. And I'm so grateful for even the family here today. Because would it be for him, I wouldn't be here. And I truly love him. And if he were to take me today, I would be so grateful just to be with him. So, sorry, I'm a crybaby. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Church. My name is Terry. I'm from Fiji. I'd like to share one of my favorite Bible verses this morning, Hebrews 11:6. Without God, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Because whosoever comes to him must believe that he exists, and God will reward those who diligently seek him. I've been wrestling with God in the desert for the longest time, my marriage relationship, and I've come to a point that I've come to realize that, you know, it's that God that matters most in my life. And today I'm thankful for his mercy that I knew every morning. I thank God that today is the day that he has made for me. I'm becoming a whole new person. I'm rededicating, recommitting my life back to God. And I thank God that today I'm a new reborn in Christ.
I mean, I don't know what much to say. I'm ready for this. I'm ready for this to symbolize as a new beginning. I'm ready to make better choices in life and make better decisions and grow closer to God. So I'm ready for this to be the start of something that draws me more closer to him. All right, man.
Doing this because I'm ready for a new beginning and to actually start getting serious about God, because back then when I was around like 8 or 9, I was just believing in it because my family did. And now I actually believe in it, and I want to start a new start with Jesus.
Yana, and I'm a crier too, but I'm here because I love the Lord and I want to rededicate my life to Him. I've been baptized, but with my boys, when they said that they wanted to be baptized, I wanted all of us to just get right and have a new commitment with the Lord.
Hey, my name is Polo. I guess they say the best for last, right, Pastor? I've been a Christ follower for a lot of years. Left the ministry, and I was about to give up, actually. I've been church hopping for, I felt like a grasshopper. I can't even count how many churches. But when we pulled up here, I told my girl, I said, this is it. This is the last church. If I don't like it, I'm done. But, you know, God led me here, and I'm very grateful. And I'm ready to start a fresh new beginning.
Yes. Amen. Come on, baby.
Got my hands back there. I push you down.
Okay. Here it comes. Come on. Come on, Antonio.
My name's Antonio, and I recently just lost my grandmother a couple months ago, and I know she's with him, and I'm ready to accept Jesus.
Yeah. Great.
Thank you.
think that's everybody,
That's everybody I have.
Well, guys, thank you for being here. Praise the Lord. And this is the fruit of your ministry here. And so we thank you for everything. Just keep on walking with the Lord. Have a great weekend and day tomorrow. Amen?
Amen.
God bless. Okay, I need a